Okay, welcome to another prehab class. So today's class is a restoration class. We're going to combine two techniques together to really just help to restore as much range of motion as we can and also activate as much of the body as we can. So we're going to combine active isolating stretching with joint articulations. The approach for class today is going to be quite simple. All I'd like you to do is be as specific as possible in trying to construct your movements, and then explore, ask for more, okay? Be gentle with yourself, right? And you can work on several different levels here. If you happen to be very tired, well then, just do what you can about asking for more. And if you're very energetic, that might actually make you able to really put forth a lot more effort when you're asking for more, especially during the active isolating stretching technique. And then when you're doing the joint articulations that follow that, you should notice a bigger range of motion or a bigger difference in your range of motion when you're all done. Okay, let's just start with some breathing. We're just gonna do some diaphragmic breathing. We're trying to get the breath into your belly. So what I'd like you to do is place your hands on your belly like so. And then just take a huge breath in. Try to inflate your belly as much as you possibly can. When you exhale, just let the breath go so that your diaphragm can just release and reflexively let all that tension out, okay? So here we go, big breath in. And then exhale, just let it go. Feel free to sigh. Good, let's do that two more times. Huge breath in. And then exhale, just let it go. And one more time, huge breath in. And then exhale, just let it go. Good. We're gonna continue with the belly breathing, and then we're gonna add on another technique. We're gonna try to help these lower ribs to articulate on the breath out. All too often when we spend too much time sitting, these lower ribs develop a rib cage flare as the intercostal muscles and the obliques forget how to actually depress your rib cage or collapse your rib cage as you exhale. So with your hands, I want you to place your hands on your lower ribs. Coach these lower ribs to collapse in as we exhale. So we're gonna actively exhale this time. We're gonna try to make the exhale nice and long. Okay, but first, breathe into your belly. Big breath in. Then hands on your lower ribs. Long exhale, coach these lower ribs to collapse in towards your spine. Good, let's do that two more times. Big breath into your belly. And then exhale, coach these lower ribs to collapse in. Good, one more time. Big breath into the belly. And then exhale, coach these lower ribs to collapse in. Beautiful. So now let's layer on a third technique here. So what I'd like you to do is try to imagine that you're blowing out birthday candles on the far side of the room. So just start with 10 birthday candles all the way over there on the far side of the room. That's gonna really force you to dig deep with your exhalation, okay? But it doesn't wanna be a big gust of wind out. It must be nice and steady, okay? So again, we're gonna breathe into the belly first. We're gonna collapse these lower ribs in, and then we're gonna try to blow out 10 birthday candles on the other side of the room, okay? So go ahead, inhale. Hands on your lower ribs, exhale. Let's do that again. Big breath into your belly. And then exhale. Good. One more time. Big breath into your belly. And exhale. Okay, let's get started warming up the body. What we're gonna do is we're gonna start with joint articulations here. We're gonna start with the toes. What I'd like you to do is just try to lift your big toe up as high as you can and then set it down. As you're lifting the big toe up, try to keep the four outside toes down. We're just gonna do 5 reps. We're just trying to get your toes to move. And if we could start moving your toes as well as your fingers, we activate more of your motor cortex, which then helps prime your body for all the other exercises that we're going to do. Good. Let's lift this big toe up one more time. Hold it up. Good. Try to keep the four outside toes down. If they're not cooperative, it's okay. Just practice more throughout the week. Good. Let's hold up for another 3, 2, 1, and then set it down. Good. So then we'll do the other four toes. So keep your big toe down, try to lift the four outside toes up, and then set them down. Up and down. Again, root that big toe down as you're lifting the four outside toes up. Good. This time, let's lift the four outside toes up and let's hold them up. Good. Hold them and try to splay your toes, spread your toes even more. We'll hold for another 3, 2, 1, and relax. Great, so now let's do the opposite. Let's lift all the toes up, and then with your big toe, just tap the ground, and then lift up again. Good. Now if you can keep the four outside toes up, as you're tapping the ground with the big toe, press into the ground, try to get a little bit stronger. We've got two more here. Good, now press down that big toe, really root it down, we're gonna hold it down. Excellent. Lift those four outside toes up a little bit more, and let's hold that big toe down for now. 3, 2, 1, and relax. Good, so now let's lift up all the toes again, and let's do the four outside toes. We're gonna press them down and lift them up. We're keeping the big toe up the entire time. Good, as you're pressing the four outside toes down, try not to curl the toes in, but just try to press them down. Good, this time let's press down and hold. Good, you're holding those four toes down. Root them down, try to get a little bit stronger. See if you can lift that big toe up a little bit more. Excellent. We'll do this for another 3, 2, 1, and relax. Beautiful. Okay, let's work the fingers now. Reach your hands out, spread your fingers, and let's just try to articulate one finger at a time from each hand. So take the thumbs, work them in for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. And then index finger down and up for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, and now middle finger down and up for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, and then ring finger down and up for 5, 4. Do your best to keep the other finger still. 3, 2, and 1. Good, and finally pinky down and up for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great. From here, let's work into the wrist, and let's also work into the shoulder capsule here. So we're going to extend the hands out like so. We want to pack the shoulder down away from the ears. Then from this position, let's go ahead and flex the wrist. Your fingertips want to touch your forearms. Do the best that you can here. Go as far as you can. Then rotate your fingers up. Good. Let's do that again. Work through wrist extension this time. Fingertips trying to touch your forearms, and then rotate up. We'll do that again. Wrist flexion, fingertips trying to touch your forearms, and then rotate up. And then wrist extension, fingertips try to touch the forearms, rotate up. Good. Let's do a couple more reps, and let's just ask for a little bit more. So flex, really try to touch those forearms, and then rotate up. And now extend, really try to touch your forearms, and then rotate up. Good. One more time. Flexing, then rotate up, and extending, and then rotate up. Excellent. Okay, so now we've kind of primed the body a little bit. We started with the toes, we got into the fingers and the wrists, right? Your motor cortex is a little more active. So now we're gonna try to get deeper into the shoulders here. We're gonna add in the active isolating stretching technique here. So you're just gonna take your hands by your side. I want you to try to press your palms into your thighs here. Keep your elbows in straight. We're going to shrug up and shrug down. What may happen is that elbows may go out to the side, so try to keep those arms in. I want you to imagine that you're on the subway during rush hour, right, and it's jam-packed, and then you're trying to do this exercise. So here we go. Let's shrug the shoulders up towards your ears, come up as high as you can, and then keep squeezing up for one full second. Good, then reverse. Reach down to the ground. Fingertips literally trying to touch the floor. Keep reaching down for one full second. Good. Good, let's do that again. Shrug up, shoulders towards your ears, squeeze them up for one full second, and then reach down to the floor. Pull the armpits towards your pockets, reaching down for one full second. Good, let's do that one more time. Shrugging up, shoulders up in towards your ears, one full second, and then reach down, fingertips trying to touch the floor for one full second, and relax. Beautiful. So now we're gonna go into protraction and retraction. So what I'd like you to do is push your shoulders forward as far as you can, and then pull your shoulders back as far as you can. Good, as you do this, you wanna make sure that your head and your rib cage don't move, so it's not lurching forward like that. Keep your head still, imagine that you're balancing a book on top of your head. Let's take the shoulders forward, keep squeezing the shoulders forward for one full second. And then pull the shoulders back, squeeze those shoulder blades together for one full second. Again, go into protraction, pushing those shoulders forward, keep going for it for one full second. And then retraction, pull the shoulders back, squeeze the shoulder blades together, one full second. Good, one more time, shoulders forward, keep working forward for one full second. And then bring them back, keep working back, squeeze those shoulder blades together, one full second. And relax. Good. So now we're going to combine those two exercises and we're going to do some shoulder rolls here. These shoulder rolls are also called scapular cars or controlled articular rotations. So again, hands are by your side, keep your elbows in. Then roll the shoulders forward, up, back, and down. As you're doing this, you want to be on the outer limits of your range of motion here. So you want to be making the biggest circle possible. And you also want to go nice and slow. So notice how slow I'm going. I'm going about 1 mile per hour here. So keep it nice and slow and go as big as you can. Good. Now let's go ahead, let's pause and let's switch directions. So let's pull the shoulders back, roll them up and forward. Good, again. Biggest range of motion you can. So be on the outer limits of your range of motion here. You're trying to make the biggest circle. And you're trying to increase that circle 360 degrees around the circle. Excellent. Good, so we're gonna get even deeper into the shoulders right now by changing our arm position. We're gonna take the hands up the back, as if you're literally trying to touch the back of your heart. Okay? This is going to put your shoulder into internal rotation. This is going to constrict your movement. But do your best that you can from here to make the biggest circle possible, but keep it nice and slow. So let's go ahead, let's get started. Let's roll the shoulders forward, up, back, and down. Good. You want to make sure that your torso is not moving and your head's not moving. So stay nice and tall. Good, now check in with your speed. Go nice and slow here. Good, if you feel any clicking going on in your shoulders, that's okay. Go slower through those areas that are clicking and just try to expand the circle the best that you can. Good, now let's pause. Let's go the other direction, same thing. Nice big circle all the way around. Trying to expand the circle 360 degrees. And if you're feeling any clicking going on, just go slower through those areas. Excellent. So now we're going to go to a different position. We're going to bring the hands behind your head. What I'd like you to do is try to get really strong with your neck right now to keep your head nice and still so your head's not moving. Then hands are right behind your head, and then we're going to roll the shoulders again. I like to think that I'm rolling my armpits around. Okay? So nice and slowly, start your shoulder rolls. Trying to make it as big as possible. So go ahead, think about bringing those armpits forward, then up, then back, and then down. Good. Again, if you're feeling clicking going on in your shoulders, just go slow through those areas where your shoulder's clicking. And the more that you are practicing this exercise, the more that your muscles are going to learn how to coordinate and move your bones around without creating those clicks. Good, let's pause here. Let's go the other direction. make sure that your torso and your head stay still.
So don't compromise form for range of motion. You want to go as big as you can while keeping really good form and going slow. Last one here. So after working the shoulder girdle, we're going to try to get into the shoulder capsule. We're going to return to the active isolating stretching technique. So we're simply just going to reach the hands back as far as you can. You're going to hit your limit, and then you want to keep reaching back for one full second. Good. Then let's reach the hands up and back. You're going to hit your limit here, and just keep reaching back for one full second. Good. Now notice that my torso stays nice and rigid the entire time. You want your abdominals turned on. You want your chest up, okay? So let's go ahead and let's bring the arms down and back. So this is shoulder extension. You're gonna hit the limit here, pull the shoulders back, pull the hands back, one full second. Good, and then go ahead and reach forward and up. Now back, this is shoulder flexion. Keep reaching back for one full second. Good, and then let's go back to shoulder extension. Pull the shoulders back, reach the hands back. Keep reaching back for one full second. Good, and then let's get back to shoulder flexion. Up and back with the same touchdown. Keep reaching behind you, keep those abs engaged. One full second here. One more time, shoulder extension, reaching back, trying to touch the wall behind you, squeeze those shoulder blades together. One full second, and then reaching up and back, literally trying to touch the wall behind you. Activate those abdominals. One full second, excellent. Good. So after that, let's go into shoulder abduction and adduction. So we're basically going to hug ourselves, we're going to scissor our arms, and then we're going to open up like so. What's really important is that you want to keep your shoulders down. Don't let your shoulders creep up towards your ears. Keep them down, but also try to keep your hands up. Okay. So let's go ahead and let's start by reaching back. Literally just try to touch the wall behind you. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Keep reaching back for one full second. Good. Now cross your arms, scissor your arms. Squeeze really, really tight. Keep those shoulders down. One full second here. Good. Then open up again. Try to touch the wall behind you. Keep reaching back for one full second. Good. Now let's cross our arms again. Other arm on top this time. Squeeze in, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. One full second. Good. Then open up again. Try to touch the wall behind you. Keep reaching back for one full second. Good, and then go ahead and scissor your arms again. Switching your arms again. Squeeze those biceps into your heart. Keep squeezing for one full second. Good, let's do it one more time each one. So reach back, try to touch the wall. Keep reaching back for one full second. Excellent, and then switch. Cross your arms, squeeze it really, really tight. Keep those shoulders down, squeeze for another one full second, and relax. Good, so now after doing the active isolating stretching technique for the shoulder capsule, we're going to put our shoulders through the shoulder cars, controlled articular rotations. So we make this big circle like this, and as we're doing this, we're also twisting our arms. So your arm's doing a lot of different movements here, and it's going through its fullest range of motion, okay? So let's walk through this together, and we're going to try to be as specific as possible as you do. Start with your arms by your side, get tall through your spine, engage your core. Good, then reach your arms forward, up, and then you're reaching back as far as you can. Once you hit your limit here, twist your arms, turn your palms out to the side. So now your palms are facing out to the side. You can just slide your hands out, reach for the wall behind you, slowly lower your arms and keep twisting your arms. You're going to bring the backs of your hands to your back pockets, like so. Good. Then we're going to reverse it from here. We're going to pull the shoulders back, squeeze the shoulder blades together, then reach the hands back as far as you can. You're going to hit your limit here. Turn your palms out to the side, and then slowly let your arms slide out to the side. Coming up like you're about to dive into a swimming pool, reaching forward and down. Good. Let's try that again. So here we go, we're gonna reach forward, up, and back. We'll hit our limits here. Turn your palms out to the side.
Then keep reaching behind you. Slowly twist your arms as you slowly lower your arms. The backs of your hands will find your back pockets. Good. Then we're going to reverse it from here. So we're going to pull the shoulders back. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Slide your hands back as far as you can. You'll hit your limit there. Once you hit your limit, turn your palms out to the side. And then let your arms slide out to the side, coming all the way up, forward and down. Good. Let's add on to this by asking a little bit more for the range of motion. Okay. Let's take your arms, let's cross your arms, and then come up and back as far as you can. Good. You'll hit your limit here. Twist your palms out to the side. And then keep reaching behind you. Slow here. Don't go fast. Your body will want to go fast. Go slow. Twist your arms, bring the backs of your hands right to your back pocket. Good. Now let's reverse. Let's squeeze your shoulder blades together, reach your hands back, hit your limit here, turn your palms out to the side. Good. Then slowly reach out to the side, and you're reaching up towards the ceiling like you're about to dive into a swimming pool. Then we're going to cross our arms again. Notice which arm is on top. Excellent. We'll do it one more time. We're going to switch the arm back. We'll place the other arm on top here. So let's reach across. Other arms on top, coming up, and then reaching back. Hit your limit here. Turn your palms out to the side. Keep reaching for the wall behind you. Keep it nice and slow. Twist those arms and bring the backs of your hands to touch your back pockets. Perfect. Then reverse it. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Slide your hands behind you as far as you can. Hit your limit here, turn your palms out to the side, then slowly reach your arms out to the side, coming all the way up, and then we're going to cross our arms again, and down. Excellent. Okay, we're going to work on the neck right now. We're going to do some segmentation for the neck first. So what I'd like you to do is go ahead, reach your hands down to the ground. You want to try to keep these shoulders down the best you possibly can. So think about squeezing your armpits towards your pockets, fingertips reaching for the floor. We're going to do some lateral flexion from the neck. So we're going to tilt your head from side to side. Well, what's important is that you don't want your ear to come down. You want the top of your head to reach over to the wall over there, so you're staying long through your spine, and that we're not compressing one side of your spine as we do this. Okay. So again, reach your hands to the ground. Now take the top of your head and point the top of your head over to one wall. Good, and then come back to center. And let's do the other side. Same thing, top of the head pointing over to the other side. Good. So now we'll add in the active isolating stretching technique. So that means we're going to get to our end range. We're going to ask a little bit more for one full second. Okay. So reach for the ground. Reach the top of the head over to one side. Good. Keep reaching this direction for one full second. And then come on out. And then the other side. Top of the head going towards the other wall. Keep reaching as far as you can for one full second. And come on out. Good. Let's go back to the original side. So top of the head, reaching towards the wall. Keep reaching this way for one full second. Then come back to center. Other side, reaching the top of the head for the other wall. Keep reaching this way for one full second. Excellent. Good. Now really make sure that these hands are reaching for the ground. So anchor your shoulders down. Last time, each side. Top of the head over to one wall. Keep reaching this way for one full second. And now top of the head over to the other wall. Keep reaching this way as far as you can for one full second and relax. Good. So then we'll go into rotations. Let's take the hands to the shoulders so we actually can feel if your shoulders start to twist, okay? Eyes are gonna lead the way. Just simply look to your right and rotate as far as you can. When you hit your limit here, just keep trying to twist back for one full second, and then come on out. All right, we're just exploring. Don't force it. Just be nice and gentle. So go into the other side, looking behind you. Again, being gentle with yourself, but exploring, asking for a little bit more for one full second, and then come on back out. Good. Let's go back to the original side. So I
eyes lead the way, you're literally just trying to look behind you. Get to out of range and just ask for more for one full second. And then come on out. Good, and then the other side. Looking to your left. Hit the end of your range of motion and just ask for a little bit more for one full second. And then come on out. Good, let's do it one more time each side. So going to your right, looking behind you, one full second, and then come on out. And then the other side, looking to your left, hit your end range, and just keep looking back for one full second, and come on out. Great, so now we're gonna go into head protraction and retraction, okay? So hold on to your sternum here. You wanna make sure that you're not leaning as you're doing this. And you're literally just gonna push your head forward as if you're trying to read something that's all the way over there. So let's go ahead, let's go into protraction and keep reaching forward for one full second. And then retracting is as if what you just read is unbelievable. Just pull your face away from the wall in front of you. Keep pulling back for one full second. Good, let's try that again. So protract. Reaching forward for one full second. And then retract, pulling your head back. Keep pulling that head back for one full second. Good, let's do it one more time. Protract, looking forward, trying to read something for one full second. And then pulling the head back in retraction. Keep pulling back for one full second. And relax. Excellent. So then after that, we're gonna do some neck circles. Or neck control articular rotations, CARs. So as we do this, we're gonna focus on the nose. We're gonna try to draw a nice big circle with the nose. When you're looking up like so, what I'd like you to do is try to keep the back of your neck nice and long. So know where your hairline is, know where your shirt collar is, try to keep it nice and long as the nose goes up. That's gonna put more extension in your cervical spine, your neck, as opposed to just working through the atlas joint, which is at the top of your neck, which hyperextends your head like so. Okay, so again, back of the neck nice and long as we draw big circles with our nose. Okay, let's lock our arms down, fingers reaching for the floor. Focus on your nose now, bring your nose down towards your heart. Then slowly take your nose over to one shoulder. And then we're gonna lift that nose up towards the ceiling, trying to keep the back of the neck nice and long. Then take the nose over towards the other shoulder. And then slowly bring that nose back down towards your heart. Once you're back at your heart, change direction. So go back to the shoulder you just came from. And then slowly lift that nose up towards the ceiling, trying to keep the back of the neck nice and long. And then take the nose over to the other side and back down towards your heart. Good. Second time, just ask for a little bit more. Be gentle with yourself. Reach your hands down to the ground, nose towards your heart. Slowly take the nose over to one shoulder and then slowly bring that nose up towards the ceiling. Keep the back of the neck as long as possible. Know where your hairline is, know where your shirt collar is, keep it long. And then bring your nose over towards the other shoulder and then back down towards your heart. Good, and then go ahead and change direction, go the other way. So going back to the shoulder you just came from and then slowly lifting that nose up towards the ceiling and then taking the nose over to the other side and back down towards your heart. Good. Third time, just try to be smooth this time and just ask for a little bit more. Okay, so again, root your arms down towards the floor, fingertips literally touching, trying to touch the floor. Tip of the nose reaches towards your heart. Slowly take that nose over to one shoulder. And then slowly lift that nose up towards the ceiling. Good, and then we're just gonna ask for a little bit more as we come over towards the other shoulder. And then slowly bringing that nose back to your heart. And once we get back to the heart, that's exactly where we're going to change. We're going to switch directions. We're going to go back to the shoulder we just came from. Then we're going to slowly bring that nose up towards the ceiling, keep the back of the neck nice and long, and then taking it over towards the other side and back down towards your heart.
Okay, we're gonna work through the rest of the spine now. So what I'd like you to do is go ahead and bring your hands to your hips like so. Imagine wearing a belt. We're gonna do some pelvic tilts here. We're gonna try to point the belt buckle up towards your chin and then point your belt buckle down towards the floor. So up and then down. Good. Let's now go ahead, let's add in the active isolated stretching technique. So lift that belt buckle up. You're crunching your abdominals. Keep pulling that belt buckle up for one full second. And then go ahead and point that belt buckle down towards the floor. Keep pointing it down for one full second. Good, let's go ahead and reverse it. Belt buckle up. Crunch those abdominals for one full second. And then belt buckle down towards the floor, opening up those abdominals for one full second. Good, one more time. Belt buckle up. Crunch those abdominals for one full second. And then belt buckle down, open up those abdominals for one full second. Good, excellent. So from there, let's go ahead, let's try to curl your whole spine like so. I'll give you a side view, so we're gonna curl your spine like so, and then we're gonna open up your spine, we're gonna extend your spine like so. So with your eyes, look into your belly button, and then look up and back the best that you can. Try to keep the back of your neck nice and long here, okay? Here we go, three times. Curl your spine, try to look into your belly button, and keep curling for one full second. And then reverse it. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, park your shoulder blades into your back pockets, lift up your heart, arch your spine for one full second. Good, let's go ahead, curl your spine again, look into your belly button. Keep looking into the belly button as you're curling that whole spine for one full second. And then reverse it, arching your spine. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, park your shoulder blades into your back pockets, lift up your sternum, one full second. One more time. Curl your spine, look into your belly button. Excellent. Belt buckle points up. Crunch those abdominals for one full second. And then reverse. Lift up your chest. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Arch your spine for one full second. And then come on out of that. Excellent. So then we're going to go into some lateral flexion for your spine. So take your feet nice and wide. Get your belt buckle to point up. Our hands are literally going to try to touch either side of the room. So we're simply just gonna reach up and over like so. And then we'll switch sides like so. Let your head fall to the side too, so that you're not trying to keep your head up, okay? So we'll do this, we'll add in the active isolating stretching technique too, okay? So let's go ahead, let's reach one arm up and over, other arm under and across. Keep reaching this way for one full second, and then come out, and then switch up and over the other way. Keep reaching as far as you can for one full second, then come on out. Good, let's do that again. Up and over, reach as far as you can. Keep reaching this way for one full second, and then switching. Up and over, as well as under and across. Keep reaching as far as you can for one full second. Good, let's do one more time each side. So up and over, reaching as far as you can. Keep reaching this way for one full second. And then switching, other side. Keep reaching as far as you can this way for one full second, and relax, excellent. Good, so now take your feet nice and wide. We wanna root the feet down. We wanna keep the feet nice and still. We're gonna rotate our spine, and we're gonna do it with two reaches at the same time. So one arm goes up, other arm reaches across, wraps around like so, and then we'll switch. Again, reaching up, this will distract your spine, lengthen your spine, and then we're gonna wrap around like so. Okay, we'll add in the active isolated stretching technique here. So reach up as far as you can, wrap around, keep reaching behind you for one full second, and then come on up. Good, and then the other side. Reaching up, wrapping around, keep reaching behind you for one full second, and come on up. Good, let's do that again. Reaching up, keep reaching up as you're wrapping around. Now reach in two directions at the same time for one full second, and then come out. And then the other side, reaching up, wrapping around, reaching in two directions for one full second. Excellent. One more time, last chance to ask for a little bit more. So reaching up, wrap around, try to reach behind you as far as you can, one full second, come on out. And other side, reaching up, wrap around, keep reaching behind you as far as you can for one full second, and come on out. Excellent. So after all that, now what we're going to do, we're going to get into thoracic. thoracic spine carves. So I want you to find your sternum. I want you to imagine that there's a light pointing out of your sternum, and you want to try to shine this light around the room in a big circle. Okay? Let's help this by tucking our chin, looking at your sternum, and then also hugging ourselves. Then we're going to point that sternum down to the floor. Good. Real quick, go ahead and look at me. As I'm pointing my sternum down to the floor, my pelvis is still in neutral. So I'm not folding forward or hinging at the hips. My pelvis, my belt buckle is up. Okay, so the pelvis does not move, just articulate the spine. So point the sternum towards the floor. Then slowly point the sternum over to the right. And then slowly point the sternum up towards the ceiling. And then over to the left. And then back down towards the floor. Good. Once we're at our starting position, we'll change direction. We'll go back the way we just came. So over to your left. Then slowly lifting up towards the ceiling. And then over to your right. And coming back down. Good. So now just try to make that circle bigger. Again, imagine if there was a light here, that the light wants to make a bigger circle around the room. Okay? So sternum points to the floor. Now slowly point that sternum over to the right. Then lift that sternum up towards the ceiling. And then point the sternum over to the left. And then come back to the floor. And once you're there, back at start, we'll change directions. We'll go back the way we just came. And then slowly lift that sternum up towards the ceiling. And then over to the other side. And then slowly back towards the floor. Good. One more round. If you can, take your feet a little bit wider. That's going to keep your pelvis from twisting or rotating. Okay? And here we go. Last chance to ask for more. So sternum pointing down to the floor. Slowly take your sternum over to the right. And then slowly lift your sternum up towards the ceiling. And then go ahead and take your sternum over to the left. And then slowly point that sternum back down towards the floor. Good, and then we'll reverse. We'll go back to the left, and then we'll slowly try to point that sternum up towards the ceiling, and then slowly take that sternum point over towards the right, and then coming back down towards the floor. Excellent. Okay, so we're going to do some lateral lunges, and we're going to use the active isolating stretching technique in the lateral lunge to get deeper into the lateral lunge. So if you want to help yourself, you can grab an object like a chair or a wall or maybe a large foam roller, and you can use that, you can hold on to that for assistance. So this exercise is not about strength training right now. We're not trying to get stronger in the leg by doing reps. What we're trying to do is we're trying to get deeper into positions here. We're trying to get deeper into a lateral lunge by pulling the foot up off the ground and pulling ourselves down into the lateral lunge. We're trying to spend more time there. And the more we practice this, the deeper we'll get into our lateral lunge. So it's okay to hold on to something. You're still going to be progressing yourself as you do this. Alternatively, you can also just do this without support too, and that's fine as well. So whatever option you'd like to select, go ahead, set yourself up with an object, without an object, and we'll go ahead and we'll get started, okay? So as I alluded to before, as we perform these lateral lunges, the way we get down into lunge is that we're gonna look at our feet. We're literally gonna try to lift the foot up off the ground. So I'm gonna come down this way. I'm literally trying to lift this right foot up off the ground, and that pulls me down into lunge. And I'm going to be as deep as I can. I'll keep lifting that foot up for one full second. And then I'll come on up. And I'll do the same thing on the other side. So I'm literally trying to lift that foot up off the ground. That pulls me down. I'll keep lifting this foot up for one full second. And then I'll come on out of that. Good. And then I'm going to go ahead and adjust myself. And I'll do this again. I'm going to start with my belt buckle up. Good. Then I'll look at my foot. I'll lift my foot up off the ground. That pulls me into the lunge. Once I'm here, I'm still lifting my foot up for one full second, and then I'll come on out of that, and I'll switch sides. So same thing. Look at my foot. I'll try and pick my foot up off the ground. At the bottom of the lunge, I'm still trying full second, and I'll come on up. Good, let's do that one more time each side. So look at your foot, lift your foot up off the ground. Try to get that nice and low, keep lifting that foot for one full second, and then come on up. And then the other side, lift the foot up off the ground. That's it, get to the bottom, keep lifting that foot up for one full second, and then come on out of that. Excellent. Okay, so we're going to do some kneeling lunges, and we're going to add in the active isolating technique as well. So I'm in this kneeling position here. I'm going to lunge forward, and at my furthest end point here, I'm going to still try to lunge forward for one full second. Okay, we're going to do that three reps, but before we get started, we want to make sure that we're in a really good position. We want this ankle right underneath this knee, not out in front, but right under, if not, a little further back. Okay, then we want the belt buckle. Good. Now go ahead, use your hips, push your hips forward, lunge forward, then think about lifting that front foot up off the ground for one full second, and then push yourself out. Good. Let's do that two more times. So lunge forward, belt buckle stays up. Lift that front foot up off the ground for one full second, and then push back and relax. Good. Let's do that one more time. Belt buckle up. Lunging forward. You're going to hit your end range. You're going to keep lifting that front foot up off the ground for one full second. And then you're going to push back. And we'll switch legs. Okay, so again, let's get into a really good position here. So ankles right underneath your knee, if not a little further back. And belt buckle up. Good. Then go ahead, just lunge forward. You're going to hit your limit here. Keep lifting that foot up off the ground for one full second. And then push back. Good, let's try that two more times. So lunge forward, now try to lift that foot up off the ground for one full second, and push back. Good, we'll do it one more time. Belt buckle stays up, lunge forward, lift that foot up off the ground for one full second, and then come on back out. Excellent. Okay, so after those lunges, we affected the ankle in all those lunges. So we're going to go ahead and do some controlled articular rotations of cars for the ankle. What I like you to do is hold on to your shin. You can either hold it with both hands like this, or you can wrap around like so. What's really important is that your shin does not move. We're going to do some circles here at the ankle. We're going to circle the toes. We don't want the shin to move. We don't want that. We want to hold that shin nice and stiff. So go ahead and hold that shin still. Then take your toes and slowly draw a nice big circle. The biggest circle that you can. Go slow. It's really important to go slow. Good. Now, second time drawing a circle here, I want you to really watch your foot and notice that it skips anywhere around the circle. Okay? And it literally might skip over certain positions, certain spots of the circle. And it's going to do it involuntarily if it skips. Good. So on the third time around, what I like you to do is try to make sure that it doesn't skip. Just do your best. It's really your intention of trying to keep the foot being smooth. That's the exercise right now. Good. And then after you've completed that third circle, let's change direction. Let's go the other way. Draw a nice big circle. Watching your foot, trying to keep it nice and smooth the entire time. It's okay if it skips. Just wherever it skips in that circle, you want to come back. You want to go slow through that area, and you want to try and make it as smooth as possible. Okay? We're trying to teach the ankle how to remember those positions by going slow and being smooth. So last time here. Try to make the biggest circle possible and try to be smooth. Excellent. Now let's do the same thing on the other leg. Okay? So again, hold on to the shin, either both hands or you wrap around, and then pull the toes up towards your shin, and then slowly start to draw a nice big circle. Okay, as you're drawing this circle, watch it, try to keep it nice and smooth. Okay, it's okay if it skips. But ultimately, what we want to do is whenever we see the foot skip, We want to come back to that area, and we want to try to make it smooth, and we want to try to control our foot through the area that the foot previously skipped over. Okay, one more time, nice and slow and smooth. Let's change direction, let's go the other way. Okay, nice big circles, try to keep it nice and smooth. Okay, watching your foot. If it skips anywhere, just come back to that spot and just try to be slow and smooth. It may take a while for your foot to become smooth, like it may actually take weeks of practice. But in the long run, being able to do ankle cards nice and smoothly will lead to more stability of your foot and your ankle, which then leads to more stability throughout the entire body. Okay. So next, let's focus on the knee here. So what I'd like you to do is place your heel on the ground and take your hands, hold your kneecap here. So don't hold your shin, but hold your kneecap. Then we're going to try to twist your shin. So I'm windshield wiping my foot here, but I'm really looking at my shin bone. I'm trying to watch and see if my shin bone can rotate in and out 45 degrees, approximately. Good, so this is internal and external rotation of the tibia, right? Your knee is made to rotate, and we want to just restore that rotation, that rotational quality to the knee. Good, so that's what we're going to do. We're going to add in the flexion and the extension with the rotation. So what I'd like you to do is rotate your shin to point in, and then slowly extend your knee. Good, now as you bend your knee, rotate your shin to point out, and bend your knee as deep as possible. Good, then rotate in again, slowly extend, and then rotate out, slowly bend. Good, let's do that again. Rotate the shin in, slowly extend, try to get it nice and straight, and then rotate the shin out and slowly bend. Perfect. Pause right here, change direction. So my shin is rotated out, I'm slowly extending my knee, and I'm gonna rotate in, and I'm gonna bend my knee. Good, let's try that again. Rotate out, and extend. Then rotate in, and bend. Good, one more time. Rotate your shin out, slow on the extension. Rotate the shin in, slow on the flexion. Good. Beautiful. Let's switch sides. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so we have heels on the ground first, hands on the knee. You don't want the thigh to move. You want to keep the thigh nice and still. And then windshield wiper the foot and watch the shin bone. You want to see the shin bone rotates in and out approximately 45 degrees. Good. So once you've noticed that the shin can rotate, let's then add in the flexion and the extension. So rotate the shin in, and then slowly extend your knee, and then rotate the shin out, slowly bend your knee. Good, let's try that again. Rotate in, and extend. Then rotate that shin out, and bend. Good, one more time this direction. Rotate in, and extend. Good, and then rotate out, and bend. Good, then let's reverse. So shin's rotated out, let's extend. And then rotate in and bend. Good, again, rotate out and extend. Good, and then rotate in and bend. Good, one more time, rotate out and extend. And then rotate in and bend. Excellent. Okay, from there, let's then go down to the ground and let's do some hip carves. So we're gonna lay down on the floor like so, okay? We're gonna tuck the knees up towards your chest. We're gonna make a pillow for your head. We're gonna take the top hand, we're gonna hold on to the pelvis like so. We're gonna do some circles, hip circles here, or hip cars, control articular rotations here. We're gonna basically circle the knee around. So hold on to your pelvis, and then slowly bring your knee up towards your chest. Good, then the next movement is that you're gonna lift the knee up as high as you can towards the ceiling without moving your pelvis. Then twist the thigh and reach the foot back, Literally try to touch the wall behind you with your heel. Then slowly lower the knee down and bring your knees together. Good, let's try that again. Bring the knee up towards your chest, then up towards the ceiling. Twist and reach back as far as you can. Then slowly lower down and knees together. Good, one more time this direction. Knee up towards your chest, then up towards the ceiling. Twist and reach back as far as you can. And then slowly lower down and bring your knees together. Good, let's reverse, okay? So let's reach back as far as you can first. Good, then slowly lift that knee up towards the ceiling. Then you're gonna try to bring the knee to the outside of that top shoulder. And then finally your knees together. Good, again, reach back as far as you can. Then nice and slowly, knee up towards the ceiling. Then try to bring the knee to the outside of your shoulder. Good, and then knees together. Good, one more time. Reach back as far as you can. Slowly lift up towards the ceiling. And then knee towards your shoulder. And together. Excellent. Good, from here, let's switch sides. We'll do the same thing on the other side. So again, laying down on the ground, pillow for your head, top hand holds your pelvis. Good, then go ahead and bring your knee up towards your chest, then lift it up towards the ceiling, then reach behind as far as possible. Slowly lower down, and knees together. Good, try to go a little bit bigger now, so a little closer towards your chest, a little higher towards the ceiling, keep your pelvis still. Twist that thigh, reach behind you as far as you can. And then slowly lower down, knees together. Good, one more time. Up towards your chest, up towards the ceiling, and then twist that thigh, reach back as far as you can, and then slowly lower down, and bring your knees together. Good, now let's go the other direction. So let's reach back as far as possible. Slowly bring that knee straight up towards the ceiling, and then try to bring the knee all the way towards the outside of that shoulder, and then knees together. Good, let's try that again. So reach back, back, back. Slowly lifting up towards the ceiling and then right to the outside of your shoulder. Perfect. Good, one more time here. We're gonna reach back as far as we can and then slowly lift that knee up towards the ceiling and then try to bring that knee to the outside of your shoulder and then knees together. Excellent. Quadruped position. So you're on your hands and your knees, you're going to tuck your toes under, that's going to help with a little more stability, control of your body. And when we're here, we're going to slowly segment our spine one vertebrae at a time. We're going to do the cat-cow exercise, but we're trying to do it one vertebrae at a time. Okay? So what I'd like you to do is first get to a really good position here. Think about having wide shoulders and wide hips, and then get your spine tall. Good, then curl your spine, tuck your chin, try to look into your belly button. So this is spinal flexion, this is the cat position. From here, we're gonna slowly get out of cat one vertebrae at a time. So focus on your tailbone. Slowly point your tailbone up towards the ceiling. You'll notice that your stomach will slowly sink to the floor. Then allow your lower ribs to sink to the floor. Then allow your heart to sink to the floor. And then finally, take your eyes up towards the ceiling. Perfect. And then once you're here in cow position, we're going to slowly work our way back. Find your tailbone again. Tuck your tailbone under. Lift your waistband up towards the ceiling. Then lift your lower ribs up towards the ceiling. Then try to lift your heart up towards the ceiling. And then finally, tuck your chin and look into your belly button. Excellent. Let's do that again. Find your tailbone. Point your tailbone up towards the ceiling. Allow your stomach to sink to the floor. Allow your lower ribs to sink to the floor. Allow your heart to sink to the floor. And then take your eyes up towards the ceiling. Good. And then let's bring it back. So find your tailbone. Tuck your tailbone under. Slowly pull that waistband up. Then pull the lower ribs up towards the ceiling. And then your heart.
tuck your chin, look into your belly button. Exhale. Good. One more time in each direction. So again, find your tailbone. Lift your tailbone up towards the ceiling. Allow your stomach just to sink to the floor. And then allow those lower ribs to sink to the floor. Then allow your heart to sink to the floor as you take your eyes up towards the ceiling. Good. And then focus on the tailbone again. Tuck your tailbone under. Lift the waistband up. Slowly lift those lower ribs up. Then lift your heart up, tuck your chin, look into your belly button, and curl your spine. Exhale. Good. From here, I want you to come back to a neutral position in your spine. Then what I'd like you to do is slide your knees out as far as possible and sit your hips back. This is going to help to stabilize your pelvis for our next exercise. We're going to do some shoulder cars here. So what I'd like you to do is try to press your heart away from the floor. Then let's take the right hand, let's reach for the horizon, and then reach straight up towards the ceiling. You're gonna hit your limit here, and when you do, just turn your palm out to the side, and then let your arms slide out to the side, continue to reach up towards the ceiling. Good, then what I'd like you to do is bend your elbow, and with your thumb, try to touch the back of your heart. Once you get as close to your heart, we'll pause there and then we'll reverse. First thing we're going to do is we're going to try to squeeze your shoulder blade behind your heart and then extend your elbow. Then slowly just reach your hands up towards the ceiling and then reach forward and down. Good. And then we'll do the other hand. So take that left hand and reach forward and then up. Once you hit your limit, turn your palm out to the side. Let your arms slide out to the side and then reach behind you. Then we're going to bend the elbow. Our thumb is literally trying to touch our heart. Once you get as close as you can, we'll pause there and we'll reverse. Before we start, we want to pull the shoulder blade behind your heart, then extend your elbow. Then slowly reach your hand up towards the ceiling, reaching forward and down. Good. Let's try that again. Let's pull the shoulders away from your ears, okay? Let's press your heart away from the floor so that we're protracting and also depressing our shoulders. Good. Then take that right hand, reach forward and up. Hit your limit, turn your palm out to the side. Slowly reach behind you. And then we're going to bend the elbow. We're going to try to touch the back of our heart. Excellent. And then we'll reverse. We're going to pull the shoulder blade behind your heart first. Then slowly extend the elbow. And then reach up towards the ceiling, reaching forward and down. Perfect. Other arm. So again, pack your shoulders down, press your heart away from the floor, take that left hand, reach forward and up, hit your limit, turn your palm out to the side. Let your arms swing out to the side slowly, reach behind you, and then bend your elbow, and literally try to touch the back of your heart with your thumb. Then we're going to reverse. We're going to pull the shoulder blade behind your heart first, extend the elbow second, reach the hands up towards the ceiling, and then reaching forward and down. Good, one more time each side, okay? Keep those shoulders packed down away from your ears. Press your heart away from the floor. Take your right hand, reach forward and up, hit your limit. Turn your palm out to the side, slowly reach behind you. And then we're gonna bend the elbow, literally trying to touch the back of your heart. Good, once you're there, reverse it. Squeeze the shoulder blade behind your heart, extend your elbow, slowly reach up towards the ceiling, and then reaching forward and down. Good, and then let's do the other side, okay? So reaching forward and up again, hit your limit, turn your palm out to the side, slowly reach behind you, and then we're going to bend the elbow, we're going to take that thumb, we're going to try to touch the back of your heart. That's good, then from here, let's reverse it. Squeeze your shoulder blade behind your heart, slide your hand back, reach your hand up towards the ceiling, reaching forward and down. Excellent, good. So now we'll do the same exercise for the hip, all right? So again, controlled articular rotations, just gonna focus on the hip here, and we wanna have a really good setup position first, okay? So my knees are together, and my hands are outside my shoulder width. I'm gonna press my heart away from the floor. We want to have strong shoulders here because strong shoulders are going to isolate the hip. Okay? So from this position, I'm simply going to find my right heel. I'm going to lift my right heel up towards the ceiling. Then I'm going to slowly bring that right knee out to the side, like a dog at a fire hydrant, nice and slowly. Then I'm going to squeeze that knee up towards my chest, and I'm going to bring my knees together. Good. And then I'm going to reverse direction from here. So I'm going to come back towards my chest, then knee out to the side. Then I'm going to lift that heel up, and then I'll slowly go ahead and bring that leg down. Let's switch legs now. So find your left heel, lift it up towards the ceiling. Good. Then bring that left knee out to the side, like a dog at a fire hydrant. And then slowly squeeze that knee up in towards your chest before bringing your knees together. Good. Now change directions. Bring the knee back towards your chest, then out to the side. Then lift that heel up towards the ceiling, and then go ahead and set it down. Good. So second time, what I'd like you to do is really focus on being strong with your arms. So really press the floor away. Press your heart away from the floor. Good. If you're strong with your arms, you're going to make the hips do more work. Okay? So let's find our right heel. Let's lift that right heel up as high as possible. Good. Then bring that knee out to the side. Dog at a fire hydrant, and then squeeze that knee up in towards your chest. And then knees together. Perfect. Change direction. Bring the knee back towards your chest, then out to the side. Then lift that heel all the way up towards the ceiling. And then slowly go ahead and lower that leg down and switch. Okay, other side. Lift your heel up as high as possible. Good. And then bring your knee out to the side. Dog at a fire hydrant. And then work the knee all the way up in towards your chest. And then knees together. Good. And then change direction. Knee back towards your chest. Out to the side. Lift that heel all the way up. And then go ahead and settle that leg down to the floor. Good. One more time each side. So let's go back to the right heel. Let's ask for a little bit more. So let's bring that right heel up behind us as high as possible. Pause right here. Try to lift the knee up another inch. Excellent. Now bring the knee out to the side 90 degrees and pause right there. Try to lift the knee up another inch. Good. Then bring the knee up in towards your chest. Pause right there. Try to squeeze it in a little bit tighter. And then finally bring your knees together. Good. Now let's bring it back the other way. So knee back towards your chest, then out to the side. And then slowly lift that heel up towards the ceiling. And then bring that leg down. Excellent. And then we'll switch. Okay, so other side. So lift that left heel up, nice and high, pause right here, lift it up another inch, good. And then bring the knee out to the side 90 degrees and pause there, and then try to lift it away from the ground one more inch, good. Then try to bring the knee up in towards your chest, squeeze it in a little tighter, and then finally bring your knees together. Good, and then let's bring it back the way we just came, so knee back towards your chest, then out to the side, lift that heel all the way up towards the ceiling, and then slowly lower that leg down and relax. Perfect. Okay, from here, let's go ahead and come back to standing. What I'd like you to do is bring your knees nice and wide. Okay, tuck your toes under. I want you to rock back as far as you can, and then slowly push yourself back into the bottom of a squat. Now, you can keep your hands on the ground the entire time here. You can also keep your knees on the ground too if you can't actually rock over your feet right now. That's fine. So if this is where you are, that's fine too. Okay? And if you can rock back to a low squat, then great. Good. And then what I'd like you to do is where you are, come back to that quadruped. We're going to change positions. We're going to slide your knees out a little bit further and bring your feet a little bit wider too. And then just go ahead and rock back again and see if you can find that bottom of a squat. And see if it feels a little bit better for you. Okay, and then go ahead and rock forward and come back to quadruped. Good, one more time. So maybe that the wider knees and wider feet worked, maybe they didn't. Maybe keep your knees wide but bring your feet in a little bit and see if that works. Rock back, roll through your feet, try to find the bottom of the squat. Excellent. Now wherever you are here, put your hands on the floor, lift your hips up, and then we're going to roll up one vertebrae at a time. Okay, so you simply just want to rotate your pelvis and then roll up. Think about stacking one vertebrae on top of the other vertebrae, and then slowly come all the way up, keeping your
your chin tucked into the very end.
And thanks for joining. I'll see you again soon.